Welcome to White Cheese Gaming's Kill Team videos. We're back here with Joseph, and we are doing a escalating skirmish mission. My Ultramarine Kill Team against his Night Lords. He's got pretty much almost fully painted. It looks really nice, especially compared to your last ones when it was all plastic.
Yeah, bare plastic.
Bare plastic. So at least this time we're doing pretty much mostly fully painted. Little things here and there. I don't have all my basings and unit markings on. But yeah, we're doing 200 points. It's his first one, because if you watched the previous ones, you would have seen his Night Lords not do too well. And then in the second game that was not filmed,
decimated.
Like two or three of his guys just died, straight up died, including his 100-point leader. So, yeah.
A typical campaign game.
Well, hopefully, since we're playing somewhere else, maybe it will...
Yeah, it was the place.
Definitely the place. But we're going to try this escalating skirmish, and which is deploy 12 inches on with half your team, and the other half comes in as reserves, and they get outflank. And if they already have outflank, they get acute senses. So we'll come back with the lists. And here are my Ultramarines, led by Julius Scipii. Not quite painted yet, but in the process. And over here is this chosen... Oh, he's a Invictus Suzerain. As I call him, the Suzy Q. Then we got our Chosen, who's got a Power Fist and a Bolter. And he's, since he's a Chosen, he does not have two wounds because he is not the HQ. And Julius just has a standard, he has a Legatine Axe and the Boarding Shield and a Bolt Pistol. Then I have, still no names, I got a rank and file trooper with the Vexilla. Then I have a special with the missile launcher. And then I have six tactical marines with nothing special on them other than they got Legion of the Fury if five of them are next to each other. Also, he has that as well. And there is my kill team. Now, we've done this before, and I have two renowned, so I bought the second base. I also replaced the guy that died in the last battle. So I haven't done anything else. I still have about 44 requisition points because I made lots. I made like 26 in each of the last two games. And I just haven't spent them, but eventually I will. Alright, and here is Joseph's Night Lords. Who do we got?
Alright, so they are led by the Warden Chaplain, Reese.
Okay.
And he has his chosen... Peter, with the jump pack and a special sword. Then an executioner.
That is a big sword.
Yes, it's a heavy chain blade. Merino. Then veteran tactical. Trulio with he's a sniper. He's just got a regular weapon. So and then a support tactical. A support marine, I mean, with a Volkite caliber.
Okay.
And then three just tactical marines. They're all carrying chain swords. And everybody has trophies of judgment, except him. He already has fear.
All right, so fear chest galore. Awesome. Yes. All right. We'll get back after deployment. And this game is... kind of early, so no wine yet, but we do have some cheese. We have some white cheddar with a little bit of spread there. And then we are using my Infinity terrain, because I don't have a whole lot of 40k terrain, but it works. We're apparently on some Tau world, because it's very anime-ish. And lots of terrain. We like lots of terrain kill team, because, well, I just like lots of terrain always. So that's kind of looks like a mix of industrial... complex and kind of ramshackle. Alright, so here's our deployment. I have one of my tacticals here, the Vexilla there, and I got my missile launcher up in a nice little roost. And I got Julius and Cesaro chilling with each other, getting ready to go run across the board. I deployed first, so he made sure to stay away from my close combat guys. So he's got his jump pack dude here, and then his leader and a tactical, or is that a veteran?
No, it's just a tactical.
Over there. So, We'll get on with turn one. So my tackle's just going to move over towards the base of this stairwell. And my Vexilla is going to kind of follow along. And right there. My missile launcher can't see anything, and he likes where he's at, so he's just going to stay there. And Julius is going to move over an inch, hop up an inch, and then go 4 inches over here. Or there's a ladder here, and everybody's that way. Now we're going to go this way. So 4 inches. And Cesaro's just going to follow along. And that's my movement. I left 5 tacticals in reserve. So, we're going to shoot a tactical marine with my tactical marine. We'll see if we're within range. So, after measuring, determined that not in range. So, they're just going to run instead. Kind of just hide out behind this thing that blocks line of fire. That's my turn one. Turn one, Night Lords. The passing of the measuring device.
We do pre-measuring stuff on this, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So he's got a jump pack. So yep. I'm just going to move over here.
Dun, dun, dun. Oh, man. You're hoping all your outflanks come on this one side.
Well, if they're coming over there, that might not be a bad thing.
That'll be a great thing for my close combat guys.
So you just go in and punch everybody?
Yes.
And he has a plasma pistol, but he doesn't actually have a plasma pistol.
Oh, okay. I was kind of worried about the plasma pistol.
Yeah, I think he's just got a bolter.
Alright, so no shooting, it doesn't look like.
Nope.
Apparently, he learned from the last game of staying out of line of sight of the missile launcher. Ultramarine turn two. We're going to go to reserves. So I got 5 guys that are all the same, and we'll see who comes in. Coming in on the 3. And one doesn't. So 3-4 is a 1 and a 3. So for the, and again, they're all the same. So 1 and 2 on my left, 3, 4 to the right, and 5, 6 I get to choose. They're all the same, so it doesn't really matter. All right, so 1 comes from one side, and the 3 others come from the other. Because even though that's a 6, I'm going to keep them as close together as possible. Actually, nope, he's going to come on the side with the 1. So that's where my guys are going. Alright, we'll come back after movement. So two guys come here. They're outside rapid fire range, but I want to stay out of charge range of his one lord. And at least it will kind of mitigate something. And these guys are going to move. And yes, for those of you who know what Legion, Fury of the Legion does, this is what we're setting up to do. And then there. Everybody should be able to see my target. And they can all support each other if they get charged. Now over here, these guys just came wandering on. And they kind of don't really have any targets. They're kind of just joining the fray. And then just gonna wander on down. Wander on down and wait for any Night Lords that might come over this side. Though I have a funny feeling that they won't be coming here. And my missile launcher. Still can't see anybody, but that's okay. He's got this covered. So we got some shots. I'm just going to roll them 2 at a time. 2 shots. at your, not your leader, but at your, we'll do it how you're supposed to do, one at a time. I'm going to be firing at the tactical marine. Because you have artificer armor on your leader, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we're going to do one shot. I just need a 3. That's a 1. Next shot is a 5, so that's a hit. Wounds on a 4. It's a 3. Next. Hits. Fails to wound. And last one. Hits. Fails to wound. So, great job, guys. Your turn to initiative. I'm not initiative, but who comes on?
Okay, so these two are just same guys.
Mm-hmm.
So, one comes on.
One comes on, and then the guy with the big honking sword.
And honking comes on.
All right. Yeah.
All right.
So
this guy.
Yep. 1, 2 is that side. 3, 4 is this side. 5, 6, you get to choose the side.
I think he's going to come in on this side.
Yes.
So it's just in the middle?
Anywhere you want.
Oh, anywhere on this
just
side?
Just not, no, I don't, yeah, anywhere you want.
Okay.
I just put my guys in the middle because I didn't want them to be charged.
Okay. And then this guy? He's really who I want to have.
3, so it's on this, this side here. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2 is your left, 3, 4 is your right.
So he can come out. Oh, but he can't charge.
But he can't charge the turn you come on.
Okay.
Well. All right, and then you can move. The passing of the measuring device.
Okay.
The cheese is almost gone. And we're only turn 2.
That was really good. It's the cheese's fault. Okay.
Alright, Mr. Jump Pack. He wants to jump out in front of the missile launcher, right?
Oh man, he wants to charge everybody.
Well, of course he does.
I don't think he has it.
Do you like a real tape measure?
Yeah.
Yeah, I might as try to stay away. I mean,
so here. And I think I rolled 2d6 for a charger.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He's coming for you.
Yep. And then I can rapid fire. Everybody's within 3. But the fun thing is everybody's within 3 inches of each other, so they all get the support. Okay. Shooting.
Okay, shooting.
See if you're within 12 inches for rapid fire. Okay. Yes.
Okay. And this guy, oh no, yeah, he's good.
Yeah, bolters or bolt pistols?
Let me double check on that guy, because that's the executioner. I think he's got that guy in.
Okay. So, bolt pistol.
So, a bolt pistol's still 1, though, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, I'm going to shoot with him first.
Okay.
Do I have to determine everyone else's?
Nope.
Okay, cool. So I think 3 is right.
3's the hit. 2!
Hooray!
Okay.
And he's gonna rapid fire.
Yeah, that's 2 shots. Five and a 3, so 2 hits. Needing 4s.
1 hit.
1 wound.
A wound.
And let's see what happens. I get my armor save on a 3 up. Which guy was it? This guy?
The one at the edge.
There. Okay. And I rolled a 4, so we're good.
Okay, and then this guy's also going to shoot 3.
Okay, at this guy.
Mm-hmm. So he's not going to have a...
Yeah, so 1 shot. A hit. It's
not.
And a 2. And your commander.
He has
doesn't have a plasma pistol. He has a bolt pistol.
Yeah.
So see if he's within... Well, see if he's... If anybody's within 12.
Yeah, because I don't...
Yeah, the one, yeah.
Yeah? Oh, yeah. Okay.
It's close. We'll get to you. So he...
Single, and he misses.
Okay. And then you have your jump man. He has a pistol.
Oh, yeah, he does.
So, shoot.
You hit on a 6.
Oh, nice.
And you wound on a 5. I save on a 5. Ah. Alright, so do you have any charges to declare?
Yeah, that guy.
Okay, so I got 8 shots rapid firing.
Okay, so they need 6s to hit, right?
But they need 6s to hit. Well, it's 1. And see if I can wound you.
Is that 1? It's 2, isn't it?
No, those are 4s.
Oh, did the same thing.
And I wound you.
Uh-oh.
So it's an armor save.
He is the chosen, so he's got artifice.
Oh, no. Roll a 1, I dare you. Right. Okay, he's fine. All right, now you roll your 2d6 to see if he gets in.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, he's in.
Yeah, okay.
So he goes in, and he probably gets to go for... He's probably higher initiative, right? What's his initiative?
If you issue a challenge, is it only against specialists? Or
yeah, there's... Okay. So my other guy, you can go ahead. My guys are going to pile in, because they're within 3 inches, so they can support and kill team.
Okay.
But we'll let you roll first.
Okay, so he's got 2 attacks with his saber.
What's your weapon skill? One's a hit.
It's 5.
Okay, so both hit.
Yeah.
So.
And then it's just strength.
Okay.
So I think it's just 4.
That's knee force.
Nope. They both miss.
Okay, and I have 4 attacks back. Needing 4s to hit, so that's 2. And needing 4s to wound. 2 wounds. So, 2 up armor save.
Alright.
Sure. I forgot, those are the best never roll ones.
One time they did.
Okay. And it is my turn. No wounds, I outnumber. And you... We need to check something, because kill team things are a little bit different from 40k. Okay, so I countercharged in, and he charged in, so it was plus 1 each. And then, no wounds, so it was a tie. So rolling 4 reserves. I rolled a 5. Let's see what it comes in on. 1, 2 is my left. 5, 6, I get to choose. And I'm going to choose to have it come in where the fun's at. So he's just going to come right there and be like, oh, hey, guys. What's going? Oh, dear Lord. Not good. Rest of the movement.
Can my missile launcher see somebody? Oh, yeah.
And these guys are going, we're going to miss the fight because everybody's out flanking on the other side. Take the measuring device. And they're all just going to run. So they're just going to move 6. And move another 6. Because I'm just going to do the runs now. So there's my movement. And yeah, he'll just stay where he's at. Actually, that's 12 inches. Those moves. All right, we've got a missile launcher. Does your guy with the executioner have artificer armor? The guy with the big sword?
No. No, he doesn't. All
right, so he'll just have a cover save.
Okay.
Because I'm going to shoot him with the missile launcher.
He's
dangerous. I'll miss, so it doesn't matter. On a 3. Got a 5.
Oh, no.
All right. Oh, it's almost the 1. But that's a wound. You have a cover save, or you're taken out. 5 up cover save.
No.
4. He is out. It's insta kill, so we don't roll on the thing. Score 1 for the good guys. All right. The guy just came on. Is gonna rapid fire into the tactical marine that is nearest the board edge. Needing 3s. We got a 4 and a 3. And I got 2 wounds. So on a 3 up.
Alright.
All good. And it's your turn too. So reserves.
Just the one guy. Nope.
Same guy. One, two, yeah.
You saw what happened to that other dude.
Yeah, he's like, there's missile launchers over there. Yeah. And if I go the other way, there's all sorts of dudes there.
Okay.
It's like you're coming in the charge or something. Oh, I had you a bunch of fear checks.
Oh, yeah.
We didn't do close combat. So that was the guy that he didn't hit anyways. And then the other three... Okay, so they all feared you, so they weren't hitting you. And then we need to do a close combat before we start doing all that.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So now for this round of close combat, I got one first guy, made it. Second guy, I'm going to re-roll it because of the Vexla. Yeah, he's hitting you on fives. Next guy, he's fine, and Vexla is fine. So go ahead with your attacks. You have one less because you're no longer charging. It's hitting on threes. That's all hits. Wounding on fours.
Two
wounds. Saving on threes. Two fails. So roll to see what happens.
For both of them?
Yep. He's out. He is taken out of action. And he was the guy that was fearing you. Okay. Probably why you hit him so hard. Alright, so, three attacks back, needing force.
Oh.
One hit. The Ultramarine symbols are ones and no wounds. We lost by one. So, the guy nearest the green thing, he is fine. He rolled a seven. I'm doing it on sevens. Next guy on a five, and the Vexla. Got an 8 with his minus 1, but he gets to re-roll it. Actually, no, he's not close enough. And on 7, he's fine. So we are still in combat.
Okay.
Now he's back to moving.
Okay.
You remove the dude.
Move those dudes.
Okay. And, yeah, that is all your movement. So shooting phase.
So if you rapid fire, you can't.
If you shoot your, if you shoot a rapid fire weapon such as your bolter, you cannot shoot, cannot charge.
Okay, so
but you can use your bolt pistols.
Yeah, we're just gonna do bolt pistols then.
Okay.
You
can only shoot at that guy.
Yeah. Oh, do we have to shoot while we charge, right?
Well, if you want to shoot, that's the only guy you can shoot because the rest are in close combat.
Oh, okay. Okay, we're gonna shoot him.
One hit.
Wow.
One wound.
No.
Doesn't count. Has to be in the box to count. Okay, made it. Alright. So, charging.
Okay, charging.
Declare your charge first. So I know who's a rapid fire.
Do we have to, can we charge someone else?
No.
You have to charge who you shot, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so...
Okay, I will rapid fire into him. One hit. The six. And a wound. Three up.
Alright.
He's fine. So now you roll your distance.
Okay. It's 2d6, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
He's in. Yeah. That's a 9.
Sure.
Okay, next guy.
7.
7 is going to be close. So you got the take on that thing?
6.
Ooh, it's going to be close. It's close, close, close.
Do I have 2?
I don't know where. Yes, you do.
Oh, yeah, I do.
Okay. It's going to be close.
So, that's 7.
Yeah, you got him.
This one. So these two are on him, right?
Yep.
Nobody else is piling in.
That's correct. Because they're in the other one. They're going to pile. It's just step 4. They all pile in.
So when they outnumber somebody, they get a plus 1 to hit.
Okay. So hitting on threes. Wounded on threes.
And they'll each have
two attacks.
Two? Okay.
Wait. Do they have... They have pistols and swords, right?
Yeah, they have.
So they have three attacks each. So six attacks.
Yeah, I'm paid for shorts.
So six attacks, hitting on threes.
Okay. Well, I'll roll three.
Okay. All.
All hits.
Mm-hmm. All wounds. Two fails. So roll to see what happens.
A two and a two.
Okay. I think that's just he's no. He's face up.
Okay.
This all happens at the same initiative phase, so...
Okay.
Still have to keep going.
That's the other guy.
Mm-hmm. Three hits. Can you roll a one or two with those dice? I don't think they're...
They're two.
Okay.
And two hits, though.
Two saves. But I get to swing back. I'll swing at the guy that hit him.
Okay.
I hit with a six.
Uh-oh.
I wounded on a six. He doesn't like you. He's mad. You're fine.
Yeah.
All right. That's it.
And, oh, and
so that one.
Jumpy.
Well, we'll finish that one off here in a second. Your jump guy, go ahead.
Okay.
Who's he swinging at?
That's the box guy, right?
Yeah.
Probably try to take him out.
Okay. Well, let's do some fear checks first.
Okay.
First one's fine with the four.
Well, that other guy, I don't know.
I hit on sixes, so it didn't matter.
Okay.
And you were hitting on threes, so. Okay. Actually, you hit with everything, so it didn't make a difference.
Okay. All right, so three on a Loxy.
Two. Five. Oh, wait, no. Three, because your weapon skill five.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
And then you're wounding on fours.
One wound. Oh, go ahead.
You fail. So what is it?
Two.
Okay. But it's that same initiative, so I got three attacks. Two hits. One wound. So one wound, so your armor's safe. Okay.
All right.
We'll be back in a second. Okay, we looked up the injury chart, and my guys are just face up. They'll stand up at the start of my turn. And I made all my leadership tests to not die, not run away. So my turn, no reserves. My guys will stand up. My missile launcher will hope that you roll a 1 on your armor save and hope that he hits. Let me get the...
Oh.
Yeah. And they're going to run. And for the shooting phase, I got a missile launcher shooting at your commander out in the open.
Mm-hmm.
He hits. He wounds. On a 1, he dies. He didn't die. Because he has artificer armor, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because that's what you do with all the leaders. Close combat. Do I fear you? No. Do I fear you? No. Do I fear you? No. And do I fear you? No. Let's do the 2-on-1 first.
Okay.
Go ahead with your 4 attacks. I knew I should have bought those guys close combat weapons. So, 2 hits, because you have the plus 1, because you outnumber me.
Right.
Hitting on 3s, wounding on 3s. 1. A 4 and a 2. My armor save. Made it on a 4. I don't like you. Alright, let's see if I hit. I do not. Roll the 3. Over here. Go ahead with your 3 attacks. Okay, 2 ones and okay. A 5. And no wounds. So 3 attacks back. 2 hits. No wounds. Tied combat. Yay. Reserves.
Your turn.
Okay.
He's in. One to your left. Okay. 5-6, you get to choose.
Yeah, he's going to kill me.
Come on, try and shoot the missile launcher.
That's what I was thinking about. I was like, I can just like move here.
And you can move 6 inches.
And then like move up to here so he has cover when the guy falls back. Okay. Oh, and then he's going to move up here.
Uh-huh.
Just so he can... Oh, no, you have to charge what you shoot, right?
Yes.
So he's going to... He's going to move here. He's going to charge that guy.
Okay. And probably kill him.
Okay, so on that...
Okay, so one shot, needing a 3. You hit. Needs a 4.
No.
No.
All
right. All right, charge for your chappy. Roll the stick, guys. Okay.
5.
Yeah, you're in.
So he's charging this guy.
Okay.
So we're
out. And which one do you want to do first?
Let's do this.
Okay. You hit on 3s.
4. One miss.
Hey, I'll take it. Winning on 3s.
Oh.
1. I saved it with the 5. I want to check back. Hits on a 4.
Uh-oh.
Oh, he's getting mad. He wounds on a 4. Oh, you're going to fail it now.
Oh. No. 4 attacks against that guy?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Hitting on 3s.
Power maul. So it'll be strength times 2.
Does that hit that initiative?
Yeah, the difference between this and the other power weapons is that it's concussive.
So he meant +2, not +2.
A little less scary.
But he still went on 2s, and it's AP4.
Okay. Well, one of them is. At least, no, 2 of them is.
So 2 saves. I make both of them. And go ahead to your other guy, hitting on 3s.
You'll have 3 attacks.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Also against the same guy?
Yeah, we
should. Yeah, you don't like the guy, but that makes me great world leadership checks.
2 hits.
4s.
Alright, 2 wounds. Oh my god.
Nope. Roll. 1 got through. Oh, I rolled a 2. 5, he's out. All but right. He gets a swing back. I got 3 swings.
Right.
2 hits. 1 wound.
Okay.
On Raptor Man.
Okay.
Just 1. So I lost by 2. 3. First guy on 5s. He's running. Next guy, he's running. So initiative for the first guy. And second guy. Do you want to pursue or not? Should probably share a roll.
Yeah.
Okay. So, initiative off. You need to roll a 6. To get. Okay. Mm-hmm. And you're going to catch one guy, but you're not going to get the other one. Your chaplain?
So, what does he...
You need to roll a 6. But you didn't. But because this guy caught 2, he got the one guy that didn't run very far.
Okay.
And then we run 9 inches. So we're about here. Okay. You get to consolidate 3 inches. D6 inches.
Oh.
For each one.
So chaplain and the jump pad guy.
So not very far.
Sorry, buddy.
Hey, dog came running.
Scoot over, and then you can just scoot over.
Okay.
And
That's it.
Yeah, that's it.
All right, my movement.
Oh, no. Power X, man. And Power Fist. Thank you.
Oh, that's your guy. Mm-hmm. Hey. I got make a leadership test, I forgot. ACs. I'll just rapid fire somebody.
Yeah.
All right. My missile launcher is going to shoot him. You shot at me. I'll shoot at you. Yeah. I'll hit.
Oh, no.
All wounds.
No, no, no.
You have a five up cover save. He's dead. Again, because it's double his toughness, he doesn't roll on the injury chart. I will. This tactical marine will shoot your raptor man. You'll hit both times with fives. He'll wound once. Eventually, you'll roll a one, but not today. All right. My leader is going to shoot your raptor man. He'll hit. He will not wound. My chosen will shoot your commander.
Okay.
Will hit. Will wound. And then I got four rapid firing shots at your commander. One hit. Has to be in the box. No wounds. Charging. My leader is going to charge your raptor guy. All day. And I completely forgot about the Ultramarine's tactics of rerolling ones to wounds. If somebody's already hit you.
Yeah.
My chosen's going to shoot charge. And all day with that 10. Fear test. This guy is fine because he's now he's not fine. He fears you, and everybody's plus one leadership because of they get to use his leadership because he is the commander. So okay. Forgot.
So you're good.
I'm good. We're good. That's a 9. Last one. We're fine. We'll do the two on one first. So you got your four attacks. Hitting on threes. Booting on threes. Saving on threes. Okay. And I will swing back. Okay. Drawn combat. Raptor. You get to go first.
That guy's not bulky, is he?
He is. You know what? I don't think he is. Okay. So you're hitting on threes because I'm weapon skill 5.
Okay. Wow.
Okay. So all you right. Feared me.
I guess.
I got 3 attacks because he has 2 base and then he's charging.
Oh, but the shield doesn't let him get that one.
That's right. Plus, the weapon's a specialty weapon.
Oh, okay.
It's a legatine, so it's strength 4. AP 2.
If you're bringing your shield, you should bring a special weapon.
Yeah. Hitting on 4s. That's 1 hit. Wounding on 4s. You take a wound. You don't have an armor save. Unless I ignore your armor.
Oh, no.
Unless you have a refractor field.
No, he just has artificer.
You have one or two wounds.
But he's only got one wound, so.
So let's see what happens.
Oh, God.
I rolled a 5. You're out of here.
Sorry, buddy.
Over here, on your chaplain. Your chaplain goes first. I'm weapon skill 5, so you're hitting on 4s. Okay. And you're wounding on 2s. 2 wounds. I'm saving on 2s. Both saved. He has 3 attacks on the charge with his power fist. Hitting on 3s, because you said your weapon skill is 4?
Yeah.
I hit all. Wounding on 2s? But you have a invulnerable save, though.
Yeah, I do.
Good, because you have to make 3 of them.
Okay.
Or you're out.
I just remember that this was
it's probably 4 up.
4 plus?
So three.
Three.
All right. Oh, he made them all.
That's crazy.
Here's the fun thing. He lost combat because I charged.
Oh, no.
But is he fearless?
Yeah.
He's fearless? Then.
And I forgot he actually gives like a 6-inch bubble of zealot.
Okay.
Not that it would affect anything.
No. Because on the first round of combat, everybody kind of hit on the first go.
Mm-hmm.
All right. We're going to pause. All right. It is his, and I get to consolidate, and I will consolidate over here. Well, I'm cheating. I'll consolidate over there. Because that guy needs some help. I think my chosen can take out his leader, because statistically, the leader should have been dead. Okay. Your turn five. Night Lords. Your movement and shooting phase is rather quick.
Okay. Oh no! I forgot my guy that splatted. I thought I had one more over there.
See the U?
Yes.
He has a U there.
I had noticed.
He's got a U.
I was like, no. All right. Yeah, this is going to go quick. There's two on that
Okay,
guy.
So I got a fear test.
Yeah.
We're good. I rolled okay. Seven.
Three
hits.
And two.
Two. Oh, you're going to fail now. You're like, oh, the leader's here. The leader's here. I'm saved. Yeah, he failed an armor save. Rolled his wounds. Roll a five or six.
Five.
Yep. Just as he still gets to go because it's all the same initiative. Okay. He gets each guy gets consolidated to 6 inches.
Yeah, we might as well just. Okay, so.
They're not in a good spot.
That's
that okay.
One. And then other one.
They both go 2 inches. Okay. Right. Oh, there we are. Well, there's your tape measure there.
I think he's just gonna.
Stay an inch away.
Oh, you have to stay an inch
away. Yeah.
Okay, then he's just gonna.
Yeah, so that you can support.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh. Okay, I probably want to move away from him. Huh.
Yeah.
So I can shoot at him if he comes for us.
Well, yeah, you get to shoot him if he comes for. And yes, he's going to be coming for you.
If. I don't like that's a big if.
Okay, your chaplain gets to go before my chosen.
Okay.
One hit, two hits. Two hits. And wounding on twos.
Oh.
Both. And saving on twos. Oh, he failed one. Oh no, what happened? Roll.
Six? A six. Now it's
out. He's out. Oh man. That changes that's where my boss is going.
Yeah.
Oh man, that's. Oh. Okay.
Well.
So let's see if the game continues. I think that's game over, man. Game over.
No. Okay.
So that was the end of the game, and at the end it was Joseph had 108 points left, and I had 97. So it's a victory for the Night Lords. Though if he got another turn, I think my leader would have put a smackdown on his. I got 14 requisition points for partaking, and then I got first blood, and then I killed two specialists, and he got 16 for taking part, winning, and one specialist. And by taking out that specialist, that's what's got him to win too. So now we're going to determine injuries, and I had 4 core and one specialist, and he had 2 specialists and 1 core. So I'm going to let him go first. So core first. One or two, he's dead. He's dead.
No.
And I have 4 tactical marines. And one dies, just like last time. I got it. And then my Vexla, who's a little bit different. He's dead too. And now your specialist.
So executioner first.
Mm-hmm. 3. 4 recovery.
Alright, and then the chosen?
4 recovery. 6. And my chosen? 3 full recovery. So I lost 2 guys, and he lost 1 guy. And that is our game. We'll be back with the roundup. Alright, well,
That was a good one.
Yeah.
That was down to the wire. If it'd gone in the turn. Yeah. But you got it.
Yeah.
You got the win. You made a better list.
Yeah.
And the last game, he had all this.
95 points on one guy.
Yeah. And you also went, hey, there's a missile launcher. I'm not going to deploy across from him out in the open.
I had a 5+ cover save.
Yeah. Have that work out for you in this one. Too. I mean, that's a good point. Still, yeah. 5+ is not very good for when you want to save your guys, because dead executioner in close combat probably would have torn things up.
Yeah.
Because we were in that close combat from like turn 2 on, and they're just crazy.
Yeah, it would have been one more guy in there too.
So yeah.
And if we outnumber, you're in trouble.
Yeah. With that +1 to hit, +1 to wound, crazy. And I completely forgot most of my Ultramarine stuff.
Yeah.
Interlocking fire, where I get to reroll once the wound after somebody's hit you, or it didn't matter for the reroll charge range. But then I also had the leadership bonuses that I was didn't really need as much. The Vexilla as much, because I was missing it by 1, I would have had higher, I think. Either way, it's really fun little fight. You got a renown, I lost a renown.
Yeah, so now we're even.
But that's why I bought the base beforehand, just in case. In case I lost it, because you have to have 2 renown to buy that extra base. You lost a guy, but you still have 50 points in reserve. Yeah. And it's not a big deal. I got plenty of renown, RP to turn into points. So I'm gonna be bringing 250 points next time with that camp.
Mm-hmm.
But that's it. Oh, we finished off the cheese at least. Still no wine. But thanks for watching. Remember, you bring the wine, we bring the cheese.